Let RTC TV4 highlight your business or service in our local sports coverage. Through our platform, you have the option to use a 30-second commercial that you already have, or you can have us make a 15-second logo sponsorship for you. With 8 local schools in our partnership, we're sure you'll reach your intended audience. Sponsor with RTC TV4 today.
At CoAlliance, we understand the importance of community. After all, we've been farmer-owned since the 1920s. And now that we're a part of your community, we want to become your total agronomy solutions provider. CoAlliance offers the latest in ag technology for your operation. From field scouting and fertilizers to premium seed and precision agriculture, we can help take your operation to the next level. Put the resources of your local cooperative to work. Contact CoAlliance today.
Simplify your banking with a Simply Free checking account from First Federal Savings Bank.
At First Federal Savings Bank, we appreciate your referrals.
Refer your friends to open a Simply Free checking account.
When your friend opens a checking account, you can both receive a free gift.
It's easy as 1, 2, 3. Simply Free checking from First Federal Savings Bank, a simpler way to bank.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to John R. Nelson Gymnasium. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4. I'm Mike Bushman, and I'm joined by Chris Stevens and Colton Miller. We're bringing you the Lady Cavaliers tonight against Lakeland Christian Academy. We're going to have a boy-girl doubleheader, so we'll be following this up with a boys' Cavalier basketball game. I think this is our first year doing this with Lakeland Christian.
Correct.
So, curious to see how this works out. Always an exciting night, but I know that the from an administrative perspective, I know there's some mixed feelings about this. Logistically, it works out better. Bus-wise, it's cheaper, but then you got the lost revenues from concessions and that sort of stuff. When you split these up, you get a little more at the gate, but regardless, we'll get a look at both varsity squads tonight and what I think should be competitive and winnable games.
Yeah, we have the Lady Cavs coming in with a record of 4-6, and Lakeland Christian Cougars coming in with a record of 2-6. The Lady Cavs are coached by Tammy Shedrow, and Lakeland Christian coached by Allie Kaufman. So both teams will be looking to improve upon those records tonight.
Jeremy Becker, Rick Scott, and Mike Willington.
Cavaliers, in their most recent outing, suffered a pretty frustrating loss to Rochester Zebras. And talked to some of the Lady Cavs over the course of this week. They're just the big thing. I know that I understand that the Zebras had somebody sitting the bench who came in the second half. But one of the big things we heard, just recurring theme from those ladies, was is Rochester turned up the heat, started hitting some three pointers. We just got a little frazzled. We continue to play hard, which we always play hard. But just in terms of making shots, even just things like handling passes, when I reflect back on that game,
executing,
everything just seemed a little jittery. So hopefully we've learned a lesson there, can get it dialed down a bit. We were just talking about this, and this is true in all sports, about this in wrestling practice, about those gears up top can't be spinning too hard. You got to get that stuff slowed down a little bit and just let the game happen and be an athlete out there. And that's one thing that we have on our team. We have athletes.
So. Absolutely. And it was definitely a tale of two halves. Lady Cavs up with a 13-point lead in the first half and end up losing by 13.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
A total of a 26-point swing.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
The third quarter, I believe, was 18. We got outscored 18-2.
Yeah, it was something along those lines. It was really, really. And, again, I credit the Zebras. I mean, they came out, and you pointed out, they had a new focus in that second half. They had a plan. They executed it and really got us out of sorts.
Yeah, primarily getting points in transition and feeding the post, which they did very well.
Yeah.
And then, of course, stepping up and hitting some key perimeter shots. Looks like we're going to do the anthem here.
Turn this over to Mr. Lowry.
Thank you.
Culver.
All right, getting ready to tip things off here. You get a violation right away? I wasn't even settled enough to see what that violation was.
No, me either. I need to lock down here.
I know.
Mr. Bushman.
Lily Hayes gets it over to Sarah. And Serena. Alex Temme goes up. Again, I don't like that flick it thing that we do sometimes. Yeah. And
square
Alex is usually
up.
Better than that.
Yeah, square up.
Cavaliers in the turnover. Kenzie charges up. Kenzie. I always get Kenzie and Binkley. I always put it together. Lucky I never do it to her face.
Oh, I'm going to tell her.
Yeah, you can go ahead. I'm okay with her getting that information secondhand. I don't want to look at her while I do it. It's about a minute in, still scoreless. Calizo bringing the ball to the floor. Yeah, got a couple of Calizos here.
Yeah, sisters, both very good soccer players.
Uh-huh.
One a sophomore, one a senior.
Norris looking, doesn't like what she sees. Can't get a pass off. We get a 5 second count. Not quite. Hobbs with the ball. I think some pressure might be really useful this game. They look a little uncertain with their dribble. Norris again, defended heavily by Lily Hayes. We get a 5 count out of that. We do. Nice job, Lily Hayes, forcing the 5 count.
Yep, Lily with the turnover before, too, with the steal. All right, I think the same as the other night against Rochester, I think the Lady Cavs just offensively need to slow down a little bit.
Yeah.
Wait for that offense to come.
Nice, good. Nice feed. Good strong move. Lily Hayes puts one in. Cavs up 2-0. Another 5 second violation, just the out of bounds variety. Sarah out top to Alex. Gonna take it down the baseline. Serena swings it over to Kenzie.
Good ball movement.
Like you said, though, I think we at that moment we just had a little bit of a hurry. We could bring it back up top, let the offense run.
Cavalier ball.
What do we have there? Step over the line?
I think so. These girls are, and as you said, we got a couple good soccer players. This a team of athletes here, but looks like the team we can get to make some mistakes if we just keep moving the ball around. Nice feed inside by Sarah. Lily Hayes has the first down. 4 points for the Cavaliers.
Looks like we're looking to try to take advantage of that size advantage underneath. It's Ron Stevens used to say, the little guys give it to the big guys, and the big guys put it in the basket.
Ron Stevens is of the mindset that things, the three-point and two-point flavor should be reversed. That he said, you make anything from beyond that line, that's just luck anyway.
Nice.
Lily Hayes putting on a show. Nice passes by the Cavaliers, finding her inside. We're going to get a timeout for the Cougars. We'll take it with them. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
At Oliver Ford, we reach beyond your dealership expectation, help you in making fun decisions on your new vehicle, or let it try our professional touch by our service and parts department. We are the only Indiana new and used car dealership that has won the President Award 17 times. With over 100 years of sales experience, we're here to hold your hand from start to finish, with no pressure or gimmicks. Contact us today.
All right, folks, we're back. Cougars have the ball. Baseline out of bounds under their own basket. Cavs bringing some pressure. Kenzie Binkley picks up Colizo. Hobbs looking to center. She's going to take it on herself. Flips one up. No good. Got to get a box out. Can't just reach, ladies. That's the one drawback. I think when we do have size advantage over teams, we tend to just try to reach for the rebounds then, as opposed to getting body and boxing out. Sarah Walters picks up the foul. That's in to Tori Colizo. Gets number three there.
Number three. Rims in.
Shooter's touch rolls in.
So get another. Two for two with Cougars on the board. Kenzie Binkley brings the ball to the floor. Going to be picked up at half court. Jesse Colizo. Liliak out to Kenzie. Off Lily's foot, but Serena manages to scoop that up. Alex can go back baseline again. Contact, no foul. Finds Kenzie. A couple bounce pass. Kenzie puts it in.
Cavs picking him up full court here.
Need some pressure. Please goes in, and we'll get another shooting foul.
Cavalier foul on.
Soft calls compared to what we witnessed against Rochester. They let him play a little bit more.
Yeah, definitely.
Rochester game.
First bucket's good. We'll check Maddie Shedro on the game. Talking to Maddie's coach and mom, Tammy Shedro, actually overhearing a conversation between her and former Cavalier basketball coach Kyle Elliott, just talking about how they're going to use Maddie where they can and as much as they can, but at this point in time, what she needs to get her knee better is pretty much going to take her out for the season, and she can play on it. It's just a matter of pain tolerance and that sort of thing. So see what they can get out of this season and go from there. Varying braces they're trying as well. Over the back call from on Lily there. I guess, is that two on Lily?
Oh,
just first. Sarah was the other foul, so I was thinking of.
Which
had Kara McCrum. Another Cavalier foul there. We're racking them up here in this first quarter, so. As long as we spread them out, it's okay. We don't get anybody in foul trouble, though. We only go out about a six-player rotation.
Right.
Six and a half.
That's a senseless foul in the midcourt there, though.
Yep.
Oh!
For those of you who aren't aware at home, Serena Eckright is in fact made of plastic, so. She tends to bounce right back up. Maddie's going to initiate the offense here. A little something different than they did against Rochester. Serena shoots long two, puts it in.
Everybody on target tonight.
Nice work. Oh, that was a quick five count. We'll take it. I think the officials are rewarding our tenacious defense, and I appreciate that. One of the things I thought was interesting in the Rochester game that Coach Shedrow and staff experimented with was right there, putting Maddie in more of a spot-up shooter role and letting Kenzie continue to run the offense.
Shooter ball.
Yeah, Maddie's just unable to be able to plant and turn as you need to with as a point guard.
Well, and I think Coach, who's obviously been coaching her since she could hold the basketball, three-point bucket, just off, knows that her natural tendency, I mean, Maddie's a bulldog. She's going to go in there and try to crash the paint and drive to the lane, and you got to put her in a position offensively where that's just not her job to remove that temptation.
Cougar ball.
We got another timeout, Cougars. Yep, timeout, Cougars. They'll take a full one. We'll take it with them. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
Got that new home addition and you're keeping it covered.
Ooh, coverages now. I can help with this. Got zone coverage, man coverage, combo coverages.
I don't know, Peyton. I think more like the coverage your nationwide agent offers.
Oh, you want to go there? Home, auto, life, business, farm, boat, RV, ATV, camper, pet, motorcycle, your tour bus. Right. Did I mention farm?
Contact Jennings Insurance Agency today or visit one of our offices in Argus and Rochester.
This broadcast is brought to you in part by these local sponsors. Evans Agency in Rochester, offering farm liability, farm personal property, and farm outbuilding policies, all customized to fit your insurance needs. Let Judy help you protect all of your possessions. Online at evansagencyrochester.com. First Federal Savings Bank is your local mortgage lender with six locations throughout North Central Indiana. Trust the professionals at First Federal Savings Bank. Online at firstfederalbanking.com.
All right, Kaz back here at the Nelson. Cougars inbounding under their basket. Looking to break the Cavalier press. Tori Colizzo brings the ball to the floor, guarded by Serena Eckright. She tried to take it herself, loses control, scooped up, back down to her, puts it up and in. 10-6, Cavaliers. Ball goes off the hands, stays this way. Cavs get a sideline out of bounds play here. Lily Hayes goes baseline, takes it up herself. Oh, just off the rim there. That'll be going the other way. One too many taps at it for Lily. I almost think as much as that girl was tapping around, if Lily had the foresight to just sit down and play defense there, she could have got a little, the thing you don't want to do, which is slap it away, but I think she might have been able to get one of those. Jesse Colizzo down to the corner to Hobbs. Hobbs dribbles it off her own foot, out of bounds. Cavalier ball. Ball. Hinkley centers it. It's down to Madison. Madison gonna shoot about an 18 footer off the rim. Clizo lays it in. Down to a 2-point game. Maddie bounces it out to Kenzie. Misses everything on that one, but Lily grabs it. Back up top to Kenzie. Take it back down to Maddie. Try to take it herself. Stops, pops, and that one goes in. 12-8 Cavaliers. A little juggling around there. Cougars come up with it. They'll bring the ball back to the floor. Tori Calizo guarded by Serena Eckright again. Jessie Calizo tries taking herself, dribbles it off her foot, out of bounds, back to the Cavaliers. Checking back in for the Cougars is Jordan Gross. Checking back in for the Cavaliers is going to be Sarah Walters. For just a second there, I almost slipped in my PA announcer voice. Maddie initiates the offense. Sarah Walters down in the corner to Kenzie. Kenzie guarded by Jessie Calizo. Maddie's going to take a baseline herself. Pops it up there. Just misses. Rebound. Kenzie is going to put up another baseline shot. I think that was blocked a little bit. Regardless, we're coming back this way. Tori Calizo brings it up. She's picked up by a couple Cavaliers. Ultimately guarded by Serena. Fires it down low. Alex comes up with it. And she's going right back down. Oh! That ends the period. 12-8 Cavaliers. We'll be back in just a moment. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
At Oliver Ford, we reach beyond your dealership expectation, help you in making fun decisions on your new vehicle, or let it try our professional touch by our service and parts department. We are the only Indiana new and used car dealership that has won the President Award 17 times. With over 100 years of sales experience, we're here to hold your hand from start to finish, with no pressure or gimmicks. Contact us today.
Hello, I'm Harry Webb of Webb's Family Pharmacy.
There's been a lot of hype about CBD oil. The truth is, you better know what you're getting. St. Jean CBD products from Webb's Family Pharmacy deliver 99%...
fundraiser stuff. All right, back here at the Nelson. Coaches getting their last little bits in here before we get back from our quarter break. Cavs up four. I'd call it a solid first quarter. I'd give us a solid B. I think we got more in us, but I'm pleased with how we did the first quarter.
Yeah.
I think if we can find that magical balance between aggression and patience, we can really open the sucker up.
Bailey Binkley in for the Cavaliers.
Serena's standing there with nobody on her, but they got a couple people just in the passing lane up toward the top of the key. Ball bounces around. It's going to stay down here on Cougar's side. Ball comes into Norris. She goes up top to Jessie Calizo. Back to Norris. She shoots a long two off the front of the rim. Kenzie gobbles it up. Up ahead to Bailey. Bailey, again.
Bailey's struggling a little bit here.
Yeah. Well, and that's something you see her do a lot, and I think it's maybe a young basketball player thing. It's she's before she has full control of the ball, she's trying to look up and see where she's going to go. It's akin to the receiver running before they catch the ball kind of thing. Traveling brought in there, I think, by the nice defense of the Cavaliers. So Alex Temme goes baseline. Up and in. Cavs up six.
Cavalier basket, 32, Alex Temme.
Jesse Calizo gets across the timeline. She's guarded by two Cavaliers. That leaves Tori wide open. She's going to take it in herself, make the layup. We're back to a four-point game. Yep. Layup by Sarah Walters is no good, but she's going to shoot two.
Cougar foul on number four. Jordan Ross.
It's hard to tell, but it makes me wonder if that double team that they were doing was an unplanned double team, because once you get rid of the ball, there was nothing coming to the defense to help that out. First bucket's good. We'll check Lizzie Pugh in the game. I like seeing Lizzie Pugh get some second quarter action. Good hands. Sarah Walters comes up with it. Up ahead to Kenzie. Down a little hard to Sarah. She didn't like it. Back out to Serena. She's going to shoot the long two. Long off the rim. Going the other way. Ooh, nice screen there. Lizzie takes it, though. It's all down low. Calizo to Calizo, but Serena manages to disrupt that enough to get it back for the Cavaliers. Pressure from the Cougars. Lizzie brings the ball right at the floor. Finds Sarah. Ooh, just a little off pace. Gets her own pass, though. Misses the layup. Get an offensive foul, I believe. A loose ball foul, maybe. I don't know quite how you classify that, but Liv Miller checking the game for the Cougars. I think we're going to get Lily Hayes back in the game for the Cavaliers.
Sarah has two.
Yep. Tori Calizo gets it in to sister Jessie Calizo. Races the ball up. Liv Miller dribbles it out of bounds, but off of a Cavalier. So it'll stay this way.
Lakeland, very young.
Yeah, no kidding. I didn't even notice until you just said that.
One senior, one junior, everyone else, sophomore and freshman. Yeah.
Jessie Calizo puts one in to cut the lead to four. Lizzie swings it over to Alex. Down low to Lily. Back out to Kenzie. She just shoot a three-pointer.
Good.
Good shot there. Crowd likes that one. Ball tapped. Serena can't quite come up with it. Back up top to Jessie Calizo. Norris bounces back out to Gross. Gross shoots herself and no good. Tammy comes up with the rebound. Tammy gonna control and does. Bounce pass Lily. Lily shoots and good.
Lily Hayes on fire.
I know. Hands up. Tapped away by Serena. Kenzie comes up with it. Shoot the 15-footer. And she's good.
Binkley has fire.
Quick up 11. 5:08 left. We'll take the timeout with him. This is Culver TV. Brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
The Winning Edge is your local provider for all your school athletic needs. From providing customizable sportswear to engraving trophies, The Winning Edge strives to help teams find their edge on the playing field. Visit The Winning Edge today.
Locally owned and operated.
Oliver Ford is the largest certified pre-owned dealer in Michiana. Our inventory changes daily, and you are guaranteed the best customer service in our area. We treat you like family. Every certified pre-owned Ford includes factory-backed warranty coverage, complimentary vehicle history report, and lots more. Don't miss out on our end-of-year discounts on all of our good-as-new inventory. Rates low as we have ever seen, and the best customer service you have ever experienced.
All right, back here at Cav Land. Your Lady Cavaliers out to a 23-12 lead, but I have to imagine in the back of their heads are the Lady Zebras, who we had in a very similar situation. Actually, a more precarious situation, I'd say. We were up 13, I think we said, at one point in time. So really want to make sure we buckle in here. And as Coach said earlier in the game, don't get in too big a hurry. Just keep letting the offense run, getting the open shots. Bounce pass, bounce pass. Tori Calizo brings the ball to the floor. She's double-teamed by Lizzie and Maddie. She gets it across, though.
That's what we want with that pressure, is that frantic.
Yep.
Frantic pass. We had nobody there to
three-point basket
intercept.
Off the rim. Good position by Alex, but not by anybody else. So Maddie has the ball. Maddie centers it. Back to Alex, who's going to shoot a three-pointer. Nope, doesn't like it. Going baseline. Nice drop step. Cavs up 13. Maddie's calling for help. I don't blame her. That knee's not going to chase somebody down the floor riding him like that.
Cougar foul on number 24, Liv Miller. Her first, team third.
A foul on Liv Miller. Not sure what the discussion's about. Maddie goes to get the ball across the timeline, does. Lizzie Pugh passed down to Lily Hayes.
About 2 seconds too late.
Yep. Three-point basket by Calizo. Off the rim again. Maddie comes up the rebound. She's going to bring it up herself. She's got Alex up ahead. Finds her. Alex going to take it in but doesn't like it. Kenzie up top to Maddie. Three-point bucket is off the rim.
Maddie's struggling with her perimeter shooting since she's kind of, you know, been seeing less of the court, hard to get the flow.
Well, I think, too, figuring out, you know, even though she's a drive-the-basket kind of a shooter, she's a rhythm jump shooter. And when you got that knee there and the brace there and trying to figure out exactly how you get your feet set underneath you, it's not something you can just do. Serena Eckright checks in the game for Lizzie Pugh. Free throw off the rim. Alex comes up with the rebound. Up ahead to Maddie. She's going to find Serena. Doesn't like it. Serena now stumbles to the floor, but stays here. Cavs up 11, 3:24 left. Serena Tetha Maddie. There, you got her feet set. Oh, I thought that might be good. Serena gets a putback. Cavs back up 13. Run by everybody here. Got to get ball stopped. Bounce pass stripped away by Shedrow. Gets it up ahead to Alex.
Nothing there. Pull it out.
Slow down.
There we go.
Run some offense here, ladies. Getting a little bit of a force there. We're up 13. We take our time here. Calizo to Hobbs. We'll work down to Calizo. Jump shot is good. Maddie gets the ball across the timeline. Bounce pass to Serena. Shoots off the rim. And the Cougars are looking to run. Hobbs gets the ball, tapped away by Serena. Shoots in the Cavs logo. No good. Rebounded by Kenzie. Madison back over to Kenzie. Lily's got position, calls to the ball, but she finds Maddie back door. Nice vision there by Kenzie Binkley. Good cut by Maddie and great vision by Kenzie with that pass. Steals it by Kenzie. Almost found Madison again. Again, I think Madison, not with the knee brace on, managed to come up with that ball. Tapped away by Serena. It'll stay down here. Lindsay Pucek's back in the game. And Finley Hobbs in for the Cougars. Lucy Overmeyer seeing some action here for the Cavaliers as well. Free throw shot is good. 29-18, about 91 seconds left in the first half. Lizzie up top to Alex. Alex will take it in herself. They're calling her for a travel. Big pass over the top, intercepted by Temi. Taking it herself this time, a little too strong. Back to the Cougars.
Cougar ball.
See Alina Pizer checking the game here.
Number 40, Alina Pizer.
I think Coach Shedward might be sensing the Hulk coming out in Alex there. She's about ready to sling somebody, I think. Tori Colizzo brings the ball up. It's to sister Jesse. Pass down low to Norris. Pesky defense by the young Cavaliers here. Colizzo takes it up and in. Cuts the lead to 9 as the clock ticks down past 50 seconds here.
Lakeland not willing to fade away.
No. Yeah, like I said at the beginning, they're athletes. They're competitors. Foul on the floor. Foul goes on Natalie Norris.
Called it on the floor, so be out of bounds.
Check that.
Checking in Serena and Kenzie back in the game. That's worth a shot. You just go to the free throw line, stand there. You never know. Stranger things have happened.
Power of suggestion.
Yeah, absolutely. Maddie takes one in. Floater is a little too strong. Again, that's another one of those where it's not her shot. She would normally take that extra dribble, go in, take the contact, and right. It's not a shot she's used to shooting. Lily Hayes gets it blocked. Tori Colizzo brings the ball to the floor. Chased down by Serena. Jesse Colizzo right back to... Ooh. This is the layup. It gets her own rebound. Cavaliers manage to knock it back out. Get it to Maddie Shedrow. Got 15 seconds left. Time for one shot for the Cavaliers.
Oh, there she is.
Just a little too late there, though. Got the Cougars there, too. 9 seconds left. Just hold this ball. Hold this ball. Oh. That'll do it for the first half. Your Lady Cavs up 9. We'll be back in about 8 minutes. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
At First Federal Savings Bank, we offer a wide variety of services for our customers.
We offer a variety of deposit products, such as personal and business accounts.
We pride ourselves in being one of the top mortgage lenders in Indiana.
We offer commercial lending and business checking to help with your business banking needs. Through LPL Financial, our financial services department is here to help you with your financial planning needs.
Come see us today and see how our family can help your family.
This is the 32nd time Christmas has been hosted in this house. 32 times decorating the tree. Holiday dinners. Memories. All protected by their independent agent. And the company that stands behind them. Auto Owners Insurance.
Contact Jennings Insurance Agency today or visit one of our offices in Argus and Rochester.
Only 2 score, almost nothing in the second.
All right, basketball fans, we're back with you with about 36 seconds left in this halftime break. Your Cavaliers up 9. And Coach and I were just talking as we went mute there to start with. We've been in this position a couple times this year and managed to let things rattle apart. So it's a matter of just continuing to play aggressive yet patient basketball and not let them out-athlete us by getting the game frantic, running up and down the floor, and basically mind-tricking us into making silly mistakes, which is what Rochester did a fantastic job of. They started moving fast, hit a couple three-pointers, and then, again, hands get jittery when we're catching passes. Our dribbles don't look confident, and things just kind of rattle apart from there. So very important to come out. I'd say these first 2 or 3 minutes are really going to tell us where we're at here as we go into the second half.
Which usually is the case, obviously, one of the biggest 3 minutes of the game.
Yep.
First 3 minutes of the second half.
Can that be my winter sports? This is a big play.
Yeah.
Kenzie very patiently bring the ball across the timeline. Ball tapped away, picked up. Lily's got the ball at the top. Back over to, stay under control. Nothing silly.
Easy.
Yeah, see, this is what we're talking about. Got a little turnover on offense, and now we're banging shoulders on defense. Nothing let us do it.
Oh, she just got away with a double dribble.
That's the variety you were discussing the other day,
yes.
I believe. Don't force it. Don't force it. There you go. Good.
Nice.
There we go. That's the kind of offense we want.
See, even if Sarah has no intention of doing anything to that basketball, just her being able to square up, pass fake, she's able to draw a foul there.
And before then, this is something we didn't do as good a job in the first half. Before then, that first pass that Serena had, her girl kind of had that sniffed out. I like that Serena took a second to get herself reset and get at an angle where she could get the ball down there to Sarah. Nice. Nice idea.
Have the right angle.
Yeah. We got the right idea.
Oh,
get it down
Lord.
Low. Just take some time and set it up. And again, time's in our favor. We take another 13 seconds to set up a pass like that. That only benefits us. Good job there. Making it hard for him. Somebody eating nachos in the front row almost got him shoved right in your face.
Hey, where'd you get those nachos? Brought them from home.
Long two. Now, again, this is where we find out. Take a deep breath. Run good offense. That ain't no thing. We've put in plenty of buckets tonight. As you said, balanced scoring attack. Everybody's been putting the ball in the hoop for us. So, fires it over to Kenzie. Alex going to take it down herself.
Right there.
Damn. Over the top.
I like the fact that we're obviously trying to look into the post,
yes.
But you've just got to make sure it's there.
Yeah. And again, they're not pressuring us to the point that we have to be in a big hurry. Let the ball move around the outside for a while. Let it happen.
Cougar ball.
Oh, that's not good.
What's that?
It's out on. I thought it was our ball, but yeah. It's their ball. Baseball pass. That's going to go safely out of bounds, I think. Nope, she ran it down. Good hustle.
Almost. Yeah.
Good hustle. And I'll give Serena credit there for crowding just enough to make it not a foul, but she couldn't get the ball scooped back in and couldn't get her feet underneath her.
Fine.
Yeah, I'm not going to feel great until we put a couple buckets in because we're stuck on 29 here.
Ooh, got away with a little bit
of
a travel there.
That's a three-point bucket. Get in there. Off the front of the rim.
Flat.
Calizo guarded by Binkley.
Back door.
Calizo, and she's going to shoot two.
Cavalier foul.
Sarah not happy with that foul, but that's a foul you see routinely.
Two line to shoot two. Number 3, Tori Calizo.
First shot for Tori Calizo is off the rim. Madison Shedrow checks back in. Now gives Alex Temme a break.
I thought that'd be for Sarah, yeah.
Yeah.
Sarah's got 3.
I think it was maybe supposed to be.
It was, yeah. Looking at the bench reaction there.
Yeah. Second free throw is good. Lily over to Sarah. Down the corner to Kenzie. Maddie looks inside to Lily. That's a good the offense entry. Right
That's
there.
What we're looking for.
Cavs back up 8. And that's one of the things I think having Maddie on the floor helps with, even if she can't drive the lane, that sort of stuff. I think our girls just kind of almost breathe a sigh of relief that the offense is going to work the way it's supposed to. Nice tap away by Serena. She's going to take it in. Pleaso going to get her. Nope. Up fake shots are by. Serena can't get her feet underneath her.
And she's okay.
It's like the old
she's just going to take it again.
Was it Stacey Ogden they called a plastic man in the NBA?
Nice.
Lily Hayes.
I'd say she's about 14 points right now.
I feel like you're, yeah, in that range. I know she was at, yeah, I think you're right. I think she's 12 or 14. And they've all been right from about, I think she had one jump from about 6 feet. Everything else has been about 2 feet from the basket, which is just how you want your offense to work.
Oh!
Wow.
Inadvertent head-to-head collision there.
Yeah.
And I think Calizo's going to need to see a trainer.
Yeah. Yeah, she took one. Serena's over to check, make sure she's okay. Good sportsmanship there. I don't think there was any malice there on either player. I think it was just a matter of going for the ball and not realizing the other girl was there.
Total inadvertent collision.
And Serena doesn't want any part of going or talking to Steph. And I absolutely understand the safety around concussion protocol and so forth, but Serena's also been around the block long enough to know if you don't have exactly the right look in your eye that Coach Stichter's not going to take any chances over there. So,
Calizo,
she got rattled pretty
clearly.
Good.
Clearly. What do we got going on here?
They're taking trying to decide whose ball it is. Make sure they got the right possession.
Hayes looking to add to her stats. I think the entire Cougar team a little rattled there after that.
Well, as you
collision.
Said, one of their two best players, and it's always hard to, let alone when you get a head-to-head like that. That always kind of gets everybody a little shaken up. On the floor again goes Serena, flips it out to Kenzie. Kenzie switches hands, going to take it in, dump it to Alex.
Nice.
Alex up and good. Cavaliers up 14. Well, this first half of the third period looking good for the Cavaliers. Cougars are going to take a timeout. We'll take it with them. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
RTC Fiber Communications is proud to announce the new RTC TV4 family of networks. Now you can watch 9 local video channels dedicated to covering the events that are important to you from anywhere in the world, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And you can watch for free. Just download the mobile app, our new Roku channel, or online at www.rtctv4.com. The RTC TV4 family of networks. Start watching today.
At Co-Alliance Propane, we treat our customers like neighbors because, well, that's what we are. When you trust Co-Alliance Propane as your seriously local propane provider, you're trusting a team of professionals who live, work, and watch the game from right across the county, not the country. A team that's close by and seriously dedicated to your safety and providing the best service possible. Find out more about Co-Alliance Propane's seriously local service and how you can get 50 gallons of propane free at coalliancepropane.com.
All right, folks, your Cavs up 14 back here at the Nelson with 3:39 left in the third period. Said Calizo's got some ice on her head, and she's still kind of shaken up over there.
Yeah, she was clearly disoriented there.
Yeah.
Clayser like, gets the ball over to Norris.
Lady Cavs in a 1-3-1 here, or just an interesting 2-3. Has a third, about three steals in a row there for Serena. We're in charge here.
Yeah, slow
only
down.
Only good shots.
Slow down.
Good.
That is 3-point basket, rims out. Going back the other way. Ball tapped out of bounds.
Cougar ball.
Little contact there. They let it go off the front of the rim. Serena comes up with the rebound. Maddie bounces Serena. Oh, really has one. That was a good defense by Gross right there. She timed that just about right. I almost wonder if she's been watching that on the sideline just the way Lily comes around, because she had that time to, and popped her hand up at the exactly right moment. I wouldn't even call it a block, more of a tap away. Lily didn't even get into the shooting motion. Jesse Clizo brings the ball to the floor.
Yeah, it looks like a 1-3-1. Lady Cavs are in. Oh. Yeah. Got away with a little walkie walk there.
Hobbs takes it down to Calizo. Calizo up top. Fires down inside, but broken up by a couple Cavaliers, and Alex is off to the races. Bounce pass to Maddie. Pass. Layup's good, and the foul. We're going to get Lizzie Pugh back in the game for the Cavs.
First, team second, shooting one, Shedrow.
It's one of the nice things with no JV contests. Coach is able to get Lizzie, Lucy, Alina, some of these younger girls, some real varsity minutes where, you know, stuff's a little more meaningful and that sort of stuff. It's
get used to the pace of a varsity basketball game.
And that's one thing I've noticed. Lizzie's probably taken the most minutes from our JV, and it's been a really good case study and just slowly getting acclimated. I know her first game she looked really nervous, and it just gets a little better every time, and she's starting to give the Cavs quality minutes out there, which is nice to see. Trap down there to corner. Ball's going to go out of bounds to the Cavs. Cavs up 17 with the ball. About a minute 48 left in this period. Lizzie looks down for Alex. Good entry pass. Swatted away. Bodies on the floor.
Alternating possession. Cougar ball.
The ball will be out of bounds to the Cougars. Neither crowd very pleased with the no call there, but sometimes it goes that way. Lizzie Pugh goes in. Yeah, we're up 17. No reason to go hacking at the ball like that. Just sit down and play some defense. We'll get Alina Pizer back in the game. And Bailey Binkley will also check into the game.
Giving her big sis a little break.
Norris shoots a three-pointer off the front of the rim. Lily Hayes comes up with the rebound. Swarmed by the Cougars, but gets it to Lizzie. Lizzie dumps down to Serena. Again, they're being very pesky here. Serena to inbound.
Oh, a little slap on the inbounds.
That was audible.
Yeah. I heard it through my headphones.
Alina Pizer goes to the line to put a couple buckets in. first one's good. Going to check Liv Miller back in the game. Rebound Lizzie Pugh, back down to Lily Hayes. Oh, that was off the rim. Ball's bouncing around everywhere. Don't reach too much. Oh, that's an athletic play right there. I think that's what you're referencing there, Coach. That was a nice take. Lena Pizer picks up the foul. Kalizo will get a chance for the three-point play. We need Kenzie Binkley back in the game here. Three-point play is completed. Kenzie checks in. Serena comes off. So we have the Binkley sisters on the floor now. Bailey gets it to Lily. Lena goes down to Lizzie. Lizzie finds Bailey down on the block, and she's fouled by Jesse Colizzo.
Cougar foul on number one. Jesse Colizzo, her first, team's fourth.
Good defense there by Norris. Colizzo brings the ball to the floor. Crowd gets the old countdown, fool. And there's a jump ball. It's going to go to the Cavaliers. Bailey's going to walk this one up the floor. Flips it back to says Kenzie's going to walk this one up the floor. That'll be an over and back. She would have been better off just to chase that thing down. It had been tapped by the Cougars, but once she goes ahead and dribbles, it's her ball then. Lena Pizer comes up with it. Let's back it out, girls. Not in a hurry here. Got 10 seconds left to work. All right, she's going to take it in, take the foul. She'll shoot two.
Cougar foul, number one, Lizzie Colizzo. Her second. Team Smith, in line to shoot two, Bailey Binkley.
Around the rim and out. She's got another one coming, though. Also misses a second one. Lena Pizer comes out the rebound. She'll shoot two free throws. No good, but Lily comes out the rebound, puts one in. As time's winding down, Cavs up. Extend their lead this time from 9 to 18, so double that lead. We'll take a timeout with them. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier Basketball.
Simplify your banking with a Simply Free checking account from First Federal Savings Bank.
All it takes is $50 to open the account with no minimum balance and no monthly service fees.
For a limited time, you will also receive a free gift just for opening the account. And with Instant Issue, we can give you a debit card right when you open your account, giving you immediate access to your funds.
Simply Free Checking from First Federal Savings Bank, a simpler way to bank.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
Want to know what I like best about playing basketball for my high school? I like it because it's a place where my friends get to see me play. I like it because I'm playing for someone besides myself. I'm playing for everybody in my school and every person in my community.
Indiana High School Sports.
They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
At First Federal Savings Bank, we enjoy helping first-time homebuyers. And with our premier first-time homebuyer program, there's no private mortgage insurance cost.
Only as little as 5% down is required for this program.
Talk with one of our experienced mortgage lenders and let us help you purchase your first home.
And remember, we don't want to be...
All right, folks, back at the Nelson. Lady Cougars have the ball. They're down 18. This kind of a lead firmly fits into the just don't mess it up category. It's not impossible, but we just don't mess it up. Super, super patient on offense. Clean defense.
I thought that was pretty good defense by Bailey Binkley right there.
Yeah, sure. I just mean don't reach, don't do silly things. I'm talking more of a general overview. That'll work too. No foul. See right there, just sit down, Lizzie. Let's play solid defense. Make the pass difficult. That's all you got to worry about. Hands up. Don't swat at it. See, that's what I'm saying. Don't swat at it. Hands up. She hits that. We get the ball back. Let's milk another 33 seconds. We can take off a half a minute with every offensive possession. Game over. We do that. We take off 30 seconds with every offensive possession. We only need to shoot, what do you say, two more buckets we need to put in to win this game? Second free throw by Gross is good. Take your time, Kens. Take your time. Let's keep it out here. There's nothing in there. Bailey picks up the foul.
Should be shooting 1-1 here.
Jesse Felizzo, her third. Team 7, two line to shoot a bonus, number 20, Bailey Binkley.
Get in there.
Good rebound.
I call trouble on that.
Shot up and way long. Slow down, Bailey. Slow down. Hands up. Ball's going everywhere. Calizzo shoots a three-pointer. Off the rim, no good. Run down by Lizzie, who's charging the ball to the floor. Now slow down. Slow down. Back it out. Even that. I like being at the free throw line, but we don't need that. Dribble it back out to this Cavs logo. Say, come get me. Bailey shoots a three-pointer, and that's good. Cavs out to a 20-point lead.
Straight up. Slide your feet.
Hobbs is fouled.
Cavalier foul, number 20, Bailey Binkley, her second. Team 7 to the line to shoot the bonus, number 13, Finley Hobbs.
Is also good. Walk this up. You got 8 seconds to get across. Is it 8 seconds or 10 seconds in high school?
Ten.
I think in NBA. You got 10 seconds to get across that line. Use 8.5 of them. Oh, Liv Miller has the ball stripped away. Kenzie racing back at the floor. Bailey back to Kenzie.
Make them, yep, make them come out.
Yeah, no reason to be in a rush, no reason to get frantic, yep.
No 5 second count. Good screen.
Lizzie Pugh off
put
the
it up,
rim.
Sarah.
Sarah
had a
puts
girl.
It back in. Nice job, Sarah Walters. Gets Kaz back out to a 20 point lead. Three-point bucket by Norris. That's a good shot.
That looked good from the get-go. Yeah.
Three-point basket number 10, Natalie Norris.
Billy Hayes goes back up top to Bailey. She gets out to Kenzie. Long two is good.
Kenzie shooting the ball well tonight.
She sure is. Ooh, line drive. Bounces around. That's going to be Cavs ball.
Cavalier ball. In the lineup for the Cavaliers, number 50, Lucy Overmeyer. And for the Cougars, number 22, Kara Crump.
Lucy Overmeyer checks in for the Cavaliers. We can get Serena Eckright back in as well.
In the lineup for the Cavaliers, 21, Serena Eckright.
Down low for Lucy, can't handle it. It's gonna go the other way. Wow. Foul on Kenzie. Will be shooting a bonus?
First, second, team's eight. To the line to shoot the bonus. Number one, Jesse Calizo.
Calizo's first free throw is good. Second free throw is a lot of bouncing, but also good. Cavs up 17, 4.5 left in the fourth period. Lucy down in the corner to Lily, tries to take a baseline.
Oh.
Steps out of bounds.
Cougar ball. In lineup for the Cavaliers. Number 30.
Check Madison Shedrow back in the game. Give Kenzie a break. Clizo guarded by Serena and Bailey. Pass goes harmlessly out of bounds. Cavs will take over possession. Maddie brings the ball to the floor across the Cavs logo. Let's eat some time at this possession here. Maddie kicks back to Lucy, who shoots a three-pointer off the rim. We're going back the other way. Goes over to Gross, back at the Calizo, who shoots a three-pointer. That's good. And all of a sudden, it's a 14-point game. Be careful here. Still comfortable, but a couple more of those, and we're hurting. Lily back up top to Bailey. She shoots a three-pointer off the rim. We don't need that, guys. Back that out and dribble that sucker a few times. Rebound, Lucy. It's Let's block this up, Serena. Maddie puts one in. Cavs back up 16.
Madison,
see Kaylee Hamilton looks to make her first appearance of the night.
JV girls did not play last night, so their quarters to spare. JV boys, our JV boys, went over to Lakeland yesterday and came out with a win.
Great. What's the drive over to Lakeland, Christian?
It's over. It's Warsaw, Winona, yeah. So it's probably 50 minutes.
Norris down low to Gross. Gross is fouled by Lucy. She'll shoot two.
Cavalier foul on number 50, Lucy Overmeyer. Her first. Team's nine. To the line to shoot two, number four, Jordan Gross.
First free throw is good. The second free throw is also good. Back to a 14-point lead. Bailey crosses over. Flips it over to Kaylee. And go back up top to Bailey now. Kenzie looks in the post, doesn't like it. Bailey's going to drive, ball gets tapped. Lucy loses control, going back to the Cougars here. Bailey tries to body her up, can't get it. Layup's good for Finley Hobbs.
Still in control here. Mm-hmm. Just take care of the basketball. Really don't need anything other than a layup.
Yep.
And they're going to do that to us, and we're in the close to the double bonus here.
Mm-hmm. Free throws and layups. Free throws and layups.
Cougar foul, 5, Alexis Miller. Two line to shoot the bonus, Hamilton.
Nachos and lemon heads.
Indeed. Ooh, that one misses everything. So that'd be a turnover. We're back to the
freshman nerves there.
Yeah, yeah. Calizo getting rid of the ball at the floor. Don't get in the fouling business either. We don't let him score with the clock stopped. Rebound goes to Lucy.
Oh, chin it loose. She was
can't
off
quite
to
get
the
a hold
races.
Of it back to Calizo.
She was off to the races. Floor, yeah. Just rebound, chin it.
Again,
pivot.
Trying to think too much about what the next move is instead of securing the ball.
Her second, shooting the double bonus, number one, Jesse
Calizo. Calizo's first free throw rims out. Lizzie Pugh checks back in the game. Next free throw is good. And get a foul there on Calizo. Send Kenzie to the line. Shoot two.
Cougar foul. On number one, Jesse Calizo. Her four. To the line to shoot the double bonus. Number 10, Kenzie Binkley.
She'll get another. Next free throw is good. Cavs up 12, 141 left in this period. Clezo crosses the timeline. Cross fires it across court. Good velocity on it, just telegraphed it a little too much. Ball bounces around. Kaylee Hamilton comes up with it, gets it over to Lizzie. Back it out, Lizzie. Kenzie takes baseline. Ooh, good defense there. Bailey Binkley out to Kaylee. Kenzie shoots a baseline jumper, rims out. Just past a minute left, Cavs up 12. Long two is off the front of the rim. Oh. Just off the fingertips and out of bounds. 48 seconds left.
Going to be lots of clock management stuff they can look at on film day here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Talk about decision making.
Coach Stevens, for the crowd watching at home, are we going to continue live stream all the way through, or are we going to cut this stream off and start a new stream for the next game?
Well, we will go ahead and do our outro like normal, and then as far as we're concerned, we'll be streaming. But Steve Stricker said on his end, they will cut stream there. But regardless of what you're seeing at home, we will be back.
So make sure the viewers at home don't think that we're done once that goes off the air. We're just getting in between games, and we'll be back.
We will be covering
as soon as the boys are ready
game
to start
as well. So yeah, regardless of what you see at home on the TV, we'll be back.
Yeah, just a little too big a hurry here. I think it's something to talk to these younger players about. It's too frantic for being up 12 with 33 seconds left. And again, it's one of those things where it's hard to readjust because you're coached in a certain way. And then when the only time you come into the game, it's slow down, don't freak out time. Yeah. It's hard.
And a lot of younger girls on the court, of course,
absolutely,
other than Ken's. But even going back to 3 minutes left in the game, there's a lot. There are a lot of decisions being made that need to be looked at. That we're in charge of the game.
Yeah. Well, just little things like I think like jogging the ball up the floor. That's a moment where you got a 10-second clock. Use 8.5 of those seconds. Just get the ball across the half-court stripe. Right up in her face. We'll get a jump ball. Back toward the Cougars. Three-point basket off the front of the rim. Now slow down, Bailey. 10.1 seconds left.
Cavalier ball.
Bounce pass comes in to Kaylee. Back over to Lizzie. Back over to Kaylee. She'll shoot a layup. That's good. They're going to take away the seconds of this game. Lady Cavaliers hold on. Nice win over Lakeland Christian, up 13. Again, be back here immediately after, folks, for our boys game. This has been Lady Cavs basketball. For Chris Stevens and Colt Miller, I'm Mike Bushman. This is Culver TV, brought to you by RTC TV4 with Cavalier basketball.
Hi, I'm John Oliver with a few reasons why your next pre-owned vehicle should be from Oliver Ford Lincoln. Imagine 172-point certification along with a 44-point safety inspection. We even get you a vehicle history report. It's for your peace of mind because we treat our customers like family. You even get free car washes for life. So get more for your money and more for your trade with certified pre-owned at Oliver Ford Lincoln in Plymouth.
Enjoy full-screen television viewing of the new RTC TV4 family of networks anywhere you are with our new Roku channel. Simply purchase a Roku device from RTC or any Roku retailer, connect to your in-home Wi-Fi, then download the RTC TV4 channel. It's that easy. Watch all of our live channels 24/7 for free, or subscribe to view all of our videos at your convenience. The RTC TV4 channel on Roku, another great service from RTC.